And the Speaker of the Edo State House of Assembly, Francis Okiye, on Monday congratulated Governor Godwin Obaseki and his deputy, Philip Shaibu, describing their re-election as a victory for democracy and Edo people. This is contained in a statement signed by the Speaker and made available to newsmen in Benin. On behalf of my family, members, and staff of the Edo State House of Assembly, I heartily congratulate Governor Godwin Obaseki and his deputy, Philip Shaibu, for their overwhelming victory, the statement read in part. And we still have with us in the studio Mr. Chris Nwandu, the publisher of CKN News. I want to quickly speak on, still on the Edo State election. How would you judge, you know, the of course, the elections generally? A lot of people, of course, would have thought, you know, otherwise, you know, expected, you know, maybe something different. But what are your views?
Yes. To a large extent, I would say, the conduct of last Saturday's election is one of the, I would say, probably one of the best we've had in recent years. I guess all prediction, especially in the area of violence, electoral malpractices, and the likes, Edo came out peaceful. The materials we had deployed in time. Yeah. People voted in time, collation was done in time, results were announced in time and on time. And at the end of it all, by Sunday we already had the results, and there was no issue of inconclusion, as we've always had them. There was no postponement and the likes. So everybody, every participant in that election did what they're supposed to do, and that was how and why we came up with that kind of result. And prior to that, we also could also go to the president, yeah, who also made some statement before the election, calling for peaceful conduct of the election, and calling on leaders of the various parties to eschew bitterness. Because that is where it starts. Yeah. When people start snatching ballot boxes, scaring people away from voting and the rest of them, then violence coming, and at the end of it all, compared to what we saw the last election in Kogi State, some people were expecting to see a similar thing, but yeah.
Let's also talk about that with regard to security. It wasn't maybe as violent as a lot of people had speculated that it would be. So do you think the security agencies did something different here?
It wasn't even a question of violence as people speculated to be. There was no violence. There was no violence in Edo. Over 31,000 policemen were deployed, almost the same number that was deployed to Kogi State.
Yeah.
Yes. And with other security agencies, and we didn't have violence. We had also that number of police deployed to Kogi State, and we saw the level of violence in Kogi. So it is more of the people, not more of security. Yes, the security was there to at least be able to maintain some level of law and order. But if the people within themselves have agreed that there's not going to be violence and we're going to protect our votes, then there will not be any level of... So the security was that I really commend the Inspector General of Police and other top security agents for a wonderful, for the job they did. And we can only take it to the next election. But my problem is that, can we be able to repeat this in a general election? That is the problem. You are deploying, by the time you deploy 31,000 policemen to about 32 states during a general election, which we don't have the capacity to do, then you can be able to, you see that there will be problem. It's because that this is just a one-off election in a state, and we are concentrating in just a state. But when we go, can we be able to push that narrative to a general election? We are going to conduct election in about 32 states. How many number of policemen? So here, until we start developing the idea of looking at election as a do-or-die affair, is it certain claims? People go to their offices in the morning and just during break time walk to their accreditation and vote and leave. But here we declare public holiday, we make it look like a war and a war situation. And
what do problem. You think are some of the things that we must take out of the election experience in Edo State? It definitely doesn't seem normal, you know, hearing of 30,000 policemen going to a state for just an election. So what are some of the things that you think we must take out and we must learn from this? And this is going to, from the people, the political actors, the traditional rulers, the presidency, the government agencies. What are the things that we must immediately start to...
You've said it all. All stakeholders in the polity must make sure that election is a game, and they should take it as that. And also, the political leaders, and as I mentioned earlier on, when you look at traditional rulers, they are within the grassroots, and they have a way of talking to their people. The Oba of Benin played a vital role. And don't also forget the peace committee headed by General Absalom Abubakar. That was the first time that committee is going to a state. Normally, they concentrate on the federal election and rest of them, but this is the first time they're going to a state. They went to a do state. So if we can be, our political, if they can be able to replicate that in various states, yeah. I think that we'll be able to. Then the security agencies also, this time around, we are neutral, because most often they are not. They don't do what they are supposed to do. They get more involved in politics rather than that do what they are supposed to. But this time around, they were very, very neutral, maybe because of the directive of the president. So they remained neutral and did their job the way they're supposed to be done. And that is why we have had such violence-free situation, because most often than not, politicians use the security agency to mitigate and to be able to achieve their personal ends. But where the security agencies do what they are supposed to do, you make sure that that is why we are having what. So Edo has become a clarion example of what an election should be. And I hope we'll be able to replicate that when we come to the Ondo election on the 10th of October, 2020.
Yeah. And also, you know, for general elections, you know, can these be replicated? Do you think it can, you know?
We can. It's not skyrocket. Ghana, for example, they do have election in Ghana, and you don't see that level of violence. We do have, I'm talking of Africa this time around. There used to be election in South Africa. You don't see violence. There have been some other African countries. I'm not even talking about Europe or America. Yeah. Within the African continent, where you see that people, countries conduct election, results are announced, nobody is killed. Yeah. But here, you continue seeing our politicians arming thugs. What they do is that prior to the election, they continue arming their thugs with guns and the rest of them. At the end of it all, they cause mayhem. After the election, they leave those thugs with those guns, and that in itself become a high level of insecurity because they cannot take care of them. Again, they decide to use the gun that were given to them to commit all sorts of crimes. So I believe we can be able to replicate that in this country. And so if we can be able to tailor the mindset of our security agencies to see that they should remain as neutral as possible and do what they're supposed to do. Yeah. I don't see us having this level of violence in the coming elections. But our security agencies must be able to raise up to the occasion and see themselves as patriots and not partisan politicians in the scheme of things.
Chris Nwandu, thank you so much for staying back and for speaking with us.
Thank you very much for having me.